Good morning to all of you. I welcome to all in our lecture series on classical mechanics, that is your core paper 2, belongs to first semester BSc syllabus. In our last class, we have been discussed about energy diagram. So, in detail we have been discussed for case 1, how it is hyperbola, that is your for energy greater than 0. For energy equal to 0, how it will be parabola. The path will be parabola, and for energy less than 0 or negative, how it is ellipse, and the special case when A is less than 0 but equal to minimum of the effective potential, then the path or trajectory will be circular. In detail we have been discussed in our last class, and solution of the central force motion we found this one. Okay, so here I suggest that you have to give, this is your equation number 2, I not given in that video, you give this one is your equation number 2 and this one is your equation number 3. And today class we are going to be discuss about Kepler's law. Okay, so before you have to watch this video, Kepler's law's video, I suggest to all of you that at least you go through the last video. Okay, then you can get the clear idea, understanding upon this Kepler's law, large topic. Okay, so let's start. So three laws given by the Kepler on the planetary motion. The first one is that every planet revolves around the sun in elliptical orbits, with sun situated at one of its foci. This is called as the first law of Kepler's first law, or also it is called as the elliptical orbits. That means all the planets are revolving around the sun in this path, and one of its foci, you can consider this one or this one, one of its foci sun is situated. Okay, this is the first law. Second law is that Kepler's second law is also called as the law of area, that the radius vector joining the sun and the planet sweeps out equal area in equal time. This is Kepler's second law or law of area. Here you can see that here is the sun is situated, right, and planet is revolving around the sun like this. Okay, so here you can see wherever any portion of the area we are going to be considered, that the change of area with respect to time will be always constant. That means that cover of area per second is always constant. That means you can see this area is equivalent to this area, is equal to this area. That means here, whatever the velocity of the planet, here the velocity will be larger than this. Okay, then here on the surface it moves smaller distance, here on the surface or on the orbit the planet moves larger, covers larger path. However, dA by dt, that means this area equal to this area, dA by dt always constant. Okay, so hence here the planet moves with a faster velocity than this portion. Okay, so that is your second law or law of area. And the third law is tells that square of the time period of the revolution of the planet about the sun is proportional to the cube of the semi-major axis. That means t square is proportional to a cube. So this is your semi-major axis. Okay, and this is your semi-minor axis. See, this is your major axis and this is your minor axis of your ellipse. So from here to here the distance is 2a, and here to here from here to here, the distance is 2b. Okay, so semi major axis means here to here the distance will be a. Okay, so semi major axis means half of the that distance, that will be a. So here t square, square of the time period, cube of the semi major axis, t square equal to a q, sorry, proportional to a q. That is your harmonic law or Kepler's third law. So one by one we are going to be verify. Okay, first we have to verify Kepler's first law. Okay, planets revolve around the sun under the gravitational force fr equal to minus k by r square, and its corresponding potential energy will be how much? U, which is function of r, will be minus fr dr, will be equal to minus k by r. Right, previously we get d theta. D theta is nothing but your this one. Here we are going to use this expression, d theta l by mu r square into dr by 2 by mu into e minus l square by 2 mu r square minus u whole to the power 1 by 2. This expression here we have to use, that d theta equal to l dr, this much. Let this is your equation number 1. Here for this section, this is your equation number 1. Now put u, instead of u, we have to put k by r. Then what will happen? Next page I have been written, only I have been just substituted instead of u, minus k by r. So it will be plus k by r. So it will be d theta will be equal to l dr whole divided by, same thing I have been written, nothing change, only this u, instead of u, I have been written plus minus k by r. So it will be plus k by r whole root over. Okay, now integrate both the side, this side and this side. So this side, if we are going to integrate, then it will be the limit will be theta 0 to theta, that means theta minus theta 0. Okay, so theta will be, theta 0 is going to be add to the right hand side, RHS. So theta will be equal to integration of this whole term plus theta 0. Here I have been written, where theta 0 is constant, let this is your equation number 2. For simplification, we have been considered that u equal to 1 by r, r equal to 1 by u, dr, that implies dr will be how much? Minus 1 by u square du. Now we have to substitute these values here in this equation number 2. Here you can see L written as such into dr is nothing but minus 1 by u square, this is small u, okay, u square du, minus 1 by u square du. Here mu, instead of r, we have to write 1 by u, r square means 1 by u square, 1 by u square. So in bracket, 2 by mu is there, in bracket, 2 by mu is there, e minus l square 2 mu r square. So here r square is going to be changed as 1 by u square. So if 1 by u square, then u square will be moved to numerator. So l square u square by 2 mu, l square u square by 2 mu plus k, here r substituted as 1 by u, so it will be k u to the power 1 by 2. Okay, now here this you can see 1 by u square, 1 by u square got cancelled, minus taken outside the integration, l du, here mu is going to be multiplied, that means you can see here this mu is outside the bracket, this bracket is nothing but for the root over. If this mu is going to be enter inside the root over, then it will be mu square. So it will be 2 mu square, mu is there, so another mu is going to, see this mu, if you enter into this bracket, so it will be mu square, right? Then if it will, mu square will be taken outside, then it will be root over, so we can write mu. So if here we have to write mu square, then mu, another mu is got cancelled, we can write 2 mu. Okay, no need to write these things. So this can be written as 2 mu e, other terms are same, nothing changed to the power 1 by 2 theta 0 theta 0. Okay, now theta equal to minus L du divided by 2 mu. Here 2 mu is multiplied with each term. 2 mu e minus mu is multiplied with this term. Mu got cancelled. 2 got cancelled. Only L square u square. 2 mu multiplied with this one. So it will be 2 mu ku to the power 1 by 2 plus theta 0. Okay. Now theta equal to this theta written initial. This theta 0 written first, then it will theta 0 minus, this L is divided to this term. If I am going to write this L inside this square root, then it will be L square. Okay, so it will be how much? You can see it will be du by 2 mu e by L square plus 2 mu ku by L square minus u square whole to the power 1 by 2. Okay, that means if I am going to take L square common, then whenever it will be move outside the root tower, it will be L and move to the numerator. Okay, so next, now we know the standard value of the integral. If this is the standard integration, dx by a plus bx plus c x square will be 1 by minus c root over cos inverse minus into whole into b plus 2 cx whole divided by b square minus 4ac. Now comparing with the integration, our integration is this one. Comparing with this integration, that means your du by 2 mu e by L square plus 2 mu ku by L square minus u square to the power 1 by 2. Here you can see your du dx. Here x, here x square, u square. Here c means here c will be equal to, if I am going to compare, c will be equal to minus 1. Okay, b, that means coefficient of x. Here coefficient of u is 2 mu k by L square. So b will be equal to 2 mu k by L square. A will be equal to 2 mu e by L square. A is nothing but 2 mu e by L square. So now this integral value will be equal to how much cos inverse? See, 1 by root over of minus c. Here c is minus 1. So minus of minus 1 will be 1, root over will be 1. So this term will be 1. Now cos inverse minus b plus 2 minus b minus, it will be minus, and this will also be minus b plus minus 2 cx. So it will be minus b, that means minus 2 mu k by L square, 2 mu k by L square, then minus of c into x. So here c is minus 1, then minus 2 c minus 1, so it will be plus 2, plus 2 x means u, so plus 2 e whole divided by 4 whole divided by b square minus 4ac. B is nothing but 2 mu k L square. So it will be 4 mu square k square by L to the 4. B square means will be this much. Then minus 4ac. So minus 4. A is nothing but how much? This one, 2 mu e L square. 2 mu e L square into c. C is how much? Minus 1. So here minus 4ac means, if we are going to consider c will be minus 1, so it will be plus. So plus 4 into a. 4 into a. C is minus 1, so due to that it will be plus. So 4 into 2 mu e by L square to the power 1 by 2. Okay. Now cos inverse, here we have been taken 2 mu k L square common from these two terms. So how much we can get? It will be mu u L square by mu k. U L square by mu k. Here I suggest to all of you that see, mu and u looks like alike. So if you are not going to write consciously these two letter, it will be confused step by step. So each step you have to significantly consider. This is mu and u. Concentratedly you have to write mu and u. Okay. So here 2 mu k by L square we have to taken outside. So this term will be how much? U L square by mu k. Just multiply. This will be 2u. Okay. Plus 2u minus 1 minus here 2 mu k by L square taken outside. So it will be minus 1. Right. Now 4 mu square k square by L 2 square 4. If I am going to take outside, then it is inside the root over. So it will be. So keep it inside the root over first. First we have to take outside this one, this value. It will be 4 mu square k square by L2 to the 4. If I am going to take outside, then it will be 1 plus 1 plus 2 e L square by mu k square. You just multiply this with this, you can get this one. Okay. So to the power 1 by 2. Then cos inverse, here you can see this term is 4 mu square k square by L2 to the 4. If I am going to take the root over, or if this term I am going to take outside this root over, then it will be how much? It will be 2 mu k by L square. That means equal to this much. So it will be got cancelled. So we can get this is u L square u, okay, this is u L square by mu k minus 1. Okay, so carefully you have to write u and mu looks like alike, so that carefully you have to write u L square by mu k minus 1 by this one. So it will be 1 plus, it is mistake, 1 plus 2 e L square by mu k square. Okay, let it is your equation number 4. Now we have to substitute this integral value. This integral value, that means equation number 4 in your equation number 3. What we are going to get? We are going to get theta equal to theta 0 minus cos inverse u L square by mu k minus 1 divided by 1 plus 2 e L square by mu k square to the power 1 by 2. Right. Here you can see that I have been taken theta to this side. It will be how much? Theta minus theta 0 will be equal to how much? Cos inverse this much. Right. Again I am going to take this minus to this side, will be how much? Theta 0 minus theta will be equal to plus cos inverse this much. But we know that cos theta is even function. So wait, I'm going to say to you, so that cos inverse will be this much. That means this much, this bracket will be equal to how much? Cos theta 0 minus theta. Okay, but we know that cos is a even function. That means cos theta 0 minus theta will be equal to cos theta minus theta 0. Okay, so therefore this can be written as, no need to write these things. So this can be written as cos theta minus theta 0 will be equal to, see, this will be go this side. So cos theta minus theta 0 will be equal to this much. U L square by mu k minus 1 whole divided by 1 plus 2 E L square by mu k square to the power 1 by 2. Just cross multiply, we can get this one. This numerator I written over here, and this is going to be multiplied with this one here I written. Okay, nothing changed. So now u will be equal to, this one is going to first add with this one, we can get this one, then u L square mu k. So u will be equal to mu k by L square into this whole term. Let this is your equation number 5. Now let's substitute e equal to 1 plus this much, 1 plus 2 e L square by mu k square to the power 1 by 2, and c is not considered as mu k by L square in equation number 5. Okay, and that this is your equation number 6, and c is this one, and these two things we are going to be put in equation number 5, then equation number 5 will be u equal to c into 1 plus, this has been considered as e, so it will be e cos theta minus theta 0. So initially for the solving, for our solving the integration, we have been taken as u equal to 1 by r. So instead of u can be written as 1 by r equal to c into 1 plus e cos theta minus theta 0. Let these two equations are equation number 7. Okay, now this equation 7 represents the equation of conic section with e is eccentricity and focus as the origin, as shown in figure 1. So here focus is at origin. So that means this is your equation of ellipse where focus, this focus is at origin. From this expression it has been confirmed. So from equation number 6 we have that is your 2 e l square by mu k square will be nothing but e square minus 1, because this much will be e square. See, e equal to this much to the power 1 by 2. So this much will be e square. Then this much will be e square minus 1. So from equation number 6, we can get this one, right? And by solving, we can get e equal to mu k square by 2 l square. Yes, mu k square by 2 l square into 1 by e square, which is negative. Okay, this is negative. See, if e square always less than 1, then this e will be always negative. And we studied in our last lecture that whenever e is negative, that may be case 3, that may be your case 4, in both the cases the condition is bounded motion, right? Condition is bounded motion. So for e is less than 0 or negative, it indicates that the dynamics is bounded only. Okay, bounded. So as we got your e belongs to total energy is negative, this happens if this negative value possible if e is always less than 1, right? E is always less than 1. So if e is going to greater than 1, then this term will be negative and this will be negative, so total energy is going to be positive. But here negative is going to be observed, that means e is less than 1. This result provided that planet moves around the sun in the elliptical orbit with sun at on foci. This is Kepler's first law. So it has been with the derivation, it has been proved that the revolving of the planet around the sun with a elliptical orbit where the sun is situated at the foci. Okay, so now we have to consider the second law of Kepler. To verify the second law, consider a planet move from P to P dash in a small time dt as shown in figure 2, swept out by small radius vector this one. Okay, sorry, then dt, then area swept out by radius vector, this area, this distance, suppose you can consider dl, okay, this to this distance. So dl will be how much? R into d theta. This much length is r, okay, and this angle is theta, so this arc will be dl. Suppose it will be r d theta, right? It will be r d theta. Now if it is very small, this dl is very small, then from this triangle we can found that the area of the triangle will be base and height, because this will be act as a 90 degree perpendicular as it is very small. So da, the area swept by this radial vector dA will be equal to half r into r d theta. R d theta means this is the height, r is the height, this is the base of this triangle. So r half into the base into height is r d theta, half r square d theta. So aerial velocity, if we are going to consider, that is nothing but rate of change of area, that is a dA by dt is will be half r square d theta by dt. So dA by dt can be written as half r square d theta by dt is nothing but omega. R square omega will be constant. Why we have to write the constant? Because we know that the angular momentum L is nothing but mu r square omega, where mu is the effective mass, which is constant, and r square omega is constant. So here, if L is constant, then r square omega also constant. So r square omega here it is constant. So hence dA by dt will be constant. So hence we found the aerial velocity of the planet is constant, which is a Kepler's second law. So if the planet is moving in this way, so here whatever the area swept here will be same with this one. That means here the planet moving slowly and here the planet moving faster than this. Okay, due to that we can get swifts of area, the rate of change of area always constant. Okay, now we have to consider Kepler's third law. See, Kepler's third law told us that the time period, suppose this is the sun and this is the planet revolving around the sun, the time period, that means revolving for one time, for one full revolution around the sun, time taken by the planet, suppose t, and this t square will be proportional with the semi-major axis from this to this. What is the distance? That distance aq, suppose it will be a, then t square will be aq. That we are going to be prove, or we are going to be evaluate mathematically. See, we know that L, angular momentum mu r square omega, just now we discussed that L mu, this mu r square omega, this all this thing, this expression also we have been discussed in our last class also. So r square omega will be L by mu. dA by dt, we know that 1 by 2 r square omega can be written as L by mu from the equation number 8. From the equation number 8, why I written? Because r square omega, equation number 8 is nothing but dA by dt equal to half r square omega. So instead of r square omega, one can be write L by mu. So here dA can be written as L by 2 mu into dt. Integrate both the side. What we are going to get here, we can this will be integration, this side will be it will give the full area. Okay, so this will be give the full area of the ellipse, and this side will be integrate with respect to t. That means 0 to t, total t means time period, L by 2 mu dt. So we can get L by 2 mu into t. But the area of the ellipse is nothing but pi into a. Here a is nothing but your semi-major axis length, this one. So this full from this to this is 2a, this to this, that means this length is semi double of semi-minor axis, that is 2b, and this length is 2a, and from this to this length is a. So but area of the ellipse, we know that pi into a into b. So here this value Lt by 2 mu is represents the total area of this ellipse. So Lt by 2 mu equal to pi ab can be written. So t will be equal to 2 pi ab mu by L. Now squaring both this side, we can get t square equal to 4. This is pi square, okay? Pi square a square b square mu square by L cube. But we know that the relation between b and a is nothing but b square into a square into 1 minus eccentricity square. So t square will be here, instead of b square can be written as this one. So it will be 4 pi square here a square. Here instead of b square can be written as a square into 1 minus e square, means it will be a to the power 4 into 1 minus e square. This is eccentricity, okay? E square into mu square by L square, let it is your equation number 9. Now but from the property of the ellipse, it is known that 2a double of semi-major axis is nothing but r maximum plus r minimum. That means R A is nothing but, this A is nothing but R max plus R minimum by 2. Okay, R max plus R minimum by 2. So as we discussed in our previous lecture, that this length can be ellipse or can be a radius of a circle. Okay, that means this length is fluctuating. Whenever we are going to consider e is less than 0, or e in case of bounded case, this length, that means planets moving around the sun, is a bounded case. That means if bounded case, then it may be a ellipse. That means this length, suppose here it is foci and here it is foci, here we are going to another foci. So this length, this is the middle, that means this length is going to be fluctuate. Sometimes it will be elliptical, and if the total energy will be match with the minimum effective potential, then it will be circular. Okay, so this will be fluctuate in between this path, is fluctuates ellipse and circular, in between ellipse and circular. That means R, that means this one sometimes greater, sometimes smaller. In between larger and smaller value of A, it is fluctuating, always oscillating. Okay, if it is larger, then it will be giving your ellipse. If it is smaller, then it will give you the so-called circular circle. So A, some maximum will be there or minimum will be there. So average will be R max plus R minimum by 2. So where we are going to find out the value of R, that can be found from equation number 7. We have to check the equation number 7. Equation number 7 told that 1 by R equal to C into 1 plus this one, right? Here cos theta, sorry, R will be equal to how much? If R will be this much, then 1 by R will be this much, then R will be how much? 1 by C into 1 by 1 plus E cos theta minus theta 0, right? Very simple. If 1 by R is this much, then R will be 1 by C into this much. Okay. And C value here we have to put the C value over here. So R will be equal to, if we are going to put C value here, it will be L square. See, C value is mu k by L square. Mu k by L square, if we are going to put, it will be L square by mu k into 1 by 1 plus E cos theta minus theta 0. So we found R value is this much from equation number 7. By using equation number 7, we found this one. So R value will be maximum. When it will be maximum? Whenever this value is minimum, right? This minimum, see, this is constant. So R value will be maximum. When it will be maximum? When this denominator will be minimum. When this denominator will be minimum? Whenever we are going to consider cos theta value is minimum. Cos theta value, cos minimum value is how much? Minus 1. So it will be 1 by 1 minus, here minus 1 means E. So this will be the R maximum. Likewise, R minimum, when we are going to get, when this value will be maximum, this denominator value will be maximum. When it will be maximum, then when this denominator will be maximum, at that time when cos theta is maximum, cos theta maximum value is 1. So it will be cos 1. So it will be 1 by 1 plus E. So R maximum is this one, R minimum is this one, from equation number 7 that we can get. So here directly I have been written. If you want, you can write here in shortly how these things I have been derived. So you can write in your rough. So from R equal to R max plus R minimum. R max will be L square by mu k into 1 by 1 minus E from equation number 7. Okay. And R minimum is nothing but L square by mu k into 1 by 1 plus E, whatever we found from also equation number 7. So now 2a 2a will be how much? 2a is nothing but r maximum plus r minimum. So it will be l square by mu k into 1 by 1 minus e plus 1 by 1 plus e. It will be l square by mu k into 2 by 1 minus e square. This is a minus b, a plus b formula you can use. So denominator will be 2. So l square by mu k into 2 by 1 minus e square. Here 2 got cancelled. A will be equal to l square by mu k into 1 minus e square. Let it is your equation number 10. Now you consider the equation number 9 and we have to rewrite this one. Equation number 9 is this one. 4 pi square a to the 4 1 minus e square mu square by l square. This equation I am going to write just somewhat changed. By changing somewhat, what we have to change? We have to write aq into a. Here it is a4, no, we have to write aq into a. So 4 pi square aq into mu square by l square into 1 minus e square a into 1 minus e square. Okay, a4 only written aq into a, nothing changed. So here 4 pi square aq mu square by l square. A instead of a, I have been written this one. That here also I written, put a value from equation number 10, that is l square by mu k 1 minus e square. 1 minus e square, 1 minus e square got cancelled. Here mu, another mu can be cancelled out. L square can be cancelled out. Then what we can get at last? A t square equal to 4 pi square mu aq by k. That means t square is proportional to aq, where 4 pi square mu by k is a constant. So this is your Kepler's third law. That is, if planet is moving, revolving around the sun, and this is your major axis, this is your minor axis, this is your semi-major axis length, then time period, this is t is time period of revolution square proportional to cube of semi-major axis. Okay, in this lecture we have been verified three laws, Kepler's three laws in your gravitation, most important for your exam. Often it is asking in your exam for 6 to 8 mark. So practice it. First you have to perfectly write in your note and practice and remember for your exam. And I will suggest that you have to just to remember the last expressions. Sometimes it will be required. Okay, this expression, okay, just remember. So thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you.